In this video, I will show you how you can get live stock and ETF price data in your Excel 365 spreadsheet. Excel is probably the most useful tool for investors and for traders, and Microsoft has made it a little bit easier for us to get live price and other company and ETF information in our spreadsheets. I'm going to demonstrate using the spreadsheet on the screen at the moment how we can do that. So I'm going to put a list of some stocks, and in my portfolio here I'm going to put Twitter, Amazon, IBM, Google, Oracle, and Ford, and Pfizer. The next thing I need to do is to tell the spreadsheet that these are stock type data. So I'm going to highlight them, I'm going to go onto the data tab and click stocks. I'm going to see it's recognized all of them as stocks. Got a couple that aren't quite right here. I put in Ford here and it has auto-filled that as Forward Industries. I'm just going to change that to F, Ford ticker, and it gets the correct stock. Now if I want to add more to this, I can do. So I could put in JP Morgan, Bank of America. Again, we need to make sure that it's recognizing the correct one. So there we have a selection of stocks to represent a portfolio. Now, what price data or what data might we want? Well, I'm going to say open, high, low, close, change, and volume, and what about price earnings as well? So I can do this by highlighting the stocks and clicking on here and then just choosing what I want. So I want open, next thing I want is the high, then I want the low, then I want the close, which is the same as saying the price, because of course that will change when the markets are open. I want the most recent change, I want the volume. And finally, let's have a look at price earnings. So there we have a table, and whenever the markets are open, this information will be updated. The information is taken from Morningstar, and it is quite close to the market, not close enough to trade on, but it is pretty close and accurate information. Now what we can do here to make this slightly more usable is we can convert, or we can rather change this into a table. So I'm going to just click on insert table, and we've got a table. Now before I do anything else on this, I'm going to show you how we could do exactly the same with ETFs. Now you may trade ETFs, you may invest in ETFs, or you may just be interested because they give you an idea of a broad swathe of the market. I've got a few ETFs here. Click on data, click on stocks again, and it has correctly identified all these ETFs. Now, all I want to do is take some of this data. So for my ETFs, I'm just going to literally copy and paste the tables that I entered above, and because I will just copy and paste those, I can do exactly the same for the actual data itself. I can highlight this, double click, highlight the whole thing, click insert, click table, and there I have, within a matter of minutes, I've got two tables, one showing my stock portfolio, the other one showing my ETF portfolio. Now, of course, because we have this as a table, we can filter it and sort it. So we might want to know if we're looking for value, we might want to know which is the lowest of our price earnings. We can see here it is Ford, Pfizer, and Bank of America. And which is the highest? Not much surprise there to see that Amazon.com is 92, on price earnings of almost 92. Now for ETFs, we can have a look at what is the most recent change. Of course, the open, high, low, closed data. We can also have a look at some different things. I can add some new fields in. So if I highlight this again, click on my tab here. What about the 55-week low and the 55-week high? And you can see now that it is automatically adding this data, including the title, into my table. So if we have this, we can work out a 52-week stochastic, which is an useful way to find out the relative strength of the different ETFs. I can demonstrate that now, and this would be the current price minus the low. Put that all in brackets and divide it by the current high minus the low. Close the brackets. I'm going to change this to 52-week stochastic. You can see here we now have a measure of relative strength, and this is very useful in case you're looking, if you want to invest on strength, you want to invest on weakness, you're looking for momentum, you are looking for which area, which market is performing better. So I can again sort this smallest to largest. We can see that the FTSE developed market is extremely weak at the moment, and the strongest performing is the Qs Tech following the NASDAQ 100. What else can we do? Now we have this in a table, we can go into our table tools. You may want to change the style. Else we can do, we can insert a slicer here, so we could actually pop this here, for this is the one for stocks. We'll have a look at stocks. So if I just wanted to have a look, Amazon or Alphabet, Amazon, Ford, if I wanted to have put in another one here, another slicer, I go into table tools, design, insert slicer, and I want to select it by ETFs. I've got another one here, so if I just want to have a look at the Qs or the S&P, and if we had a lot more data, this would be a useful way to drill down into the table and understand what it is telling us. Now this makes a great daily dashboard. You can see at a glance from your own desktop in your own format exactly what information, what market information you would like to see. If you enjoyed this video and you would like to learn more about using Excel to analyze your trading and investment strategies, to backtest your trading strategies, and also to manage your trading strategies, please hit the like button, please subscribe to this channel, and for more information about trading the financial markets and using Excel, please go to www.tradeinformed.com.